Have you ever realized that whenever you explain Stalker to someone, they seem to always say, "So it's a bit like Metro." Well, from that happening to me, I've decided to make a video explaining the similarities between both Stalker and Metro. Now, not only are both companies who make each game from Ukraine, but the game sort of shares the same premise. Both games sort of include the same sort of mutants, and both games include the same sort of alliances. Of course, taking apart the fact that Metro has Nazis and Communists, and Stalker borders has the military. But when you think of its backstory and certain things I'm going to show you now, you'll really change your mind on how both games are actually so similar, and you'll never look at them the same again. Have you realized in Metro 2033, when you first get up to the surface, you end up in sort of like a metro station, and whoever's taking all the time, I honestly can't remember, actually talks about this fellow. He describes him as a stalker. Well, I don't know how that's not giving it away yet, but what else is a stalker? Now, when two games sort of similar in a way, they call the games in the same universe. Well, there's one for you. Have you also realized that in both games, Metro and Stalker, the same sort of premise occurs with the anomaly? Now, the anomaly is like a nuclear phenomenon that occurs when nuke happens, when nuclear things happen. Well, in Stalker, the anomaly is seen to be dangerous and not to be approached unless you're forced to. Well, Metro shares the same story. It's something that you try to avoid or you try to keep at peace. So there's another one for you. There's also more obvious similarities, like whenever you go to buy Stalker, whenever you go to buy Metro, Amazon likes to put in the similarities either one of the games. Now, this is also quite obvious proof that this game sort of is similar by itself, not only in that factor. Well, I guess these games sort of do share the same universe, but maybe not so obviously. They just sort of are similar games and are, as Amazon would say it, frequently bought together. So I guess that's just something we sort of put against the side of all these anomalies. Now, before I end the video, I'd like to share some of the differences in both games. Now, the obvious one, and the main one, being how different the sort of exploration is in both games. Now, I love Stalker because I can just explore what is known as the Zone, which is essentially the area around Pripyat and Chernobyl, whereas Metro I still love because it remains to be atmospheric, but yet following a path and being a more of a linear atmospheric game. While both games do sort of still share the same sort of premise, they are completely different when it comes to one being, more across that field, and the other being, these awful references, and the one being going down a metro line. But both remain to be atmospheric, but yet they are different to each other in that aspect. So for that reason, I have to say that both of these games are not the same, and I would not say they're in the same universe, especially depending that both are in completely different countries.
Get out of here, Stalker!